Hello all, welcome to my YouTube channel Tango Learning. My name is Premanand. When learning any language, in our scenario, Python, we must be aware of its advantages and disadvantages. This will assist you in gaining a better understanding of how to utilize a Python programming language. Hence, in today's video, we'll be seeing about pros and cons of Python language. First, we'll see about the advantage. The features of Python forms the advantage for Python language. From the previous videos, we all know Python is a high-level programming language, which means human-readable language in short, right? But when compared to all other programming language, Python language syntax resembles like a English language, which makes Python language easier to read and understand the language. It is productive language because, in general, for a task to proceed, the programmers need to understand the task first and then they need to understand the language syntax for that particular task, right? But in Python, understanding the syntax is easy, hence the programmers can concentrate with task alone. Unlike other language, Python won't compile the program. Instead, it interpreted it line by line. If you have any error means, it will show for the particular line once we solved it. It will proceed further. Python comes under open source license, which makes it free, modify, and even allows to distribute your version of Python like Python 2.0 and Python 3.0. I mean, instead of O, we can call it as a Python 2.x and a Python 3.x. It is flexible because it can be used along with other language also, which other language is lacking. Python community is very huge, like our celebrity and politician fan base. We all know the advantage of having a huge community, right? Technically, we can have many libraries and tools along with the documentation for the benefit of the Python programmers. And also, through forums, we can easily discuss and solve our problems in different applications with respect to Python. Python includes libraries that allow developers to save time by not having to start from the scratch. Maybe this leads to some disadvantage also, I guess. We'll see this particular part in the disadvantage side. This speeds up product development because developers can now solve complex problems without rewriting code lines. Many programming languages such as C and C++ require you to change your code in order to run the program on different platforms. Here, the platforms which represents operating system like Windows, Linux. Python, on the other hand, is not same. You only need to write it once and then run it anywhere. And that's it, some general advantages with respect to Python language. Even we have many more advantages, but these are the general thing which suits for all the domain. Now we'll see other side of Python too. In the positive side of Python, we have mentioned Python is an interpreted language, which means line-by-line execution, which leads to slow execution. And another reason for the slowness is due to dynamically typed, as it needs to recognize during execution, it takes some bit time, right? Python has some issues with memory consumption. Suppose if you are working with a memory-intense application, then Python may not be the good choice, because of its flexibility in data types. One of the advantages of Python is dynamically typed, and it leads to runtime error issues also. Due to Python requires some testing and has errors that only show up only during the runtime, there are few features which leads to some drawbacks, right? Python makes coding a program much less stressful and easier. But it falls short when it comes to interacting with databases. In comparison to other popular technologies such as ODBC and JDBC, it has less developed and primitive database layer. Most businesses want to have a smooth interaction with the complex data, which makes Python difficult to use. Despite the fact that Python is a server-side language, it is not best for developing mobile applications. Python was largely incompatible with the development of Android and iOS applications. Fortunately, significant progress has been made to improve Python performance in the world of mobile application development. Kiwi and Beware are some Python libraries that were created to help developers create mobile applications. These libraries are extremely beneficial, even though they are unable to compete with other competing languages. Programming languages such as Java and Kotlin, Swift, JavaScript and others are dominating the mobile app development. Python is a simple and easy to use programming language, which is also one of its disadvantages. Python users become so familiar to its simple syntax and extensive library features that they encounter difficulties when learning other language programs. Some users believe that Java codes are unnecessary due to their complexity. As a result, Python has a very vulnerable nature and users begin to take everything lightly. Python language is not a multi-thread prototype. In simple terms, Python Global Interpreter Lock, in simple we call it as GIL, is a mutex, or in simple we call it as a lock, that allows only one thread to control the Python interpreter. Because only one thread can hold GIL at a time, you are not achieving true multi-threading process here. But to achieve true multi-threading, many people use a different Python implementation such as IronPython, JPython, or some extension with the C language also. Another disadvantage is compatible between versions. We have merged two versions like Python 2.x and Python 3.x, right? If some libraries that are developed during Python 2.x version, then it cannot be used in later part, that is 3.x version. Myself personally experienced while doing my work. This is another big disadvantage in terms with libraries, right? Many programmers prefer Python as a scripting language for quickly developing web applications. However, Python does not include built-in web development capabilities. Furthermore, the standard Python implementation does not improve the performance of web application across multiple browsers. As a result, Python developers must use a number of Python web frameworks in addition to web application development. They can, however, select from number of Python full stack web frameworks like Django, Primate, and TurboGear, and many more are there. Python lacks a number of features that other modern programming languages offer. To build web application and mobile apps in Python, programmers must rely on a variety of third-party frameworks and tools. To avoid increasing project overheads, they must use open-source frameworks and libraries. Even though we have more some disadvantages when compared to advantages, with respect to high level of specification aspects, still Python by default is popular than most of the languages. There are some simple points to justify here. People say slow in speed, right? Can you tell me the difference between 0.001 seconds and 0.01 seconds? The most likely answer is no, right? It usually doesn't matter too much to end users if your program takes a little longer to execute. It's fine as long as we don't write a program that takes centuries to execute and completely destroys the end user experience. If it takes too long also, horizontal scaling can be used to solve many bottlenecks caused by Python and make the execution faster. The primary reason for Python is so popular is that it is more productive than the other programming languages such as C, C++, and Java. It is a much more concise and expressive language that requires far less time, effort, and lines of code to accomplish the same task. Python features such as one-liners and dynamic type system enable developers to write far fewer lines of code for tasks that would require far more lines of code in other languages. Python is thus a very easy to learn programming language even for beginners and newcomers. Python programs, for example, are slower than the Java programs, but they also take much less time to develop because Python codes are 3 to 5 times something shorter than the Java codes. Python has a potential to dominate data science and machine learning related field. However, in these areas where large amount of data must be processed frequently using functional programming, the drawbacks of Python such as speed, dynamic typing, multi-threading, and some memory consumption and so on will become more apparent. If you are a Python programmer, if so, what are your thoughts? Thank you for your valuable time. You people put and will be happy if you share your comment for the betterment. Once again, thank you all for your patience, and we'll meet you up with other interesting content soon. If you found useful, please share this video with your tech friends. Happy learning.